Okay, today we are going to make this super cute, grateful board. I kind of realized that I kept cutting dry erase board, and I'm like, well, why don't I make something fun that's kind of that we can use a dry erase board with? So I'm gonna stick this in my kids' room. I think they're gonna enjoy it, but let's get to it. A lot of the things that we're gonna do today are similar to the ones that are the tools that we're going to use are similar to the ones that we've used in the past, so I'm going to jump right to it. Here's what the final product's going to look like. I have it in different colors, so you can kind of get an idea of all the different pieces, but let's jump to it. Gotta get my coffee. Okay, so starting with the text, I am going to click on my text tool. That bigger so you can see it. Okay, the fonts that I used here are let's see, hold on, today. Actually, okay, so I'm gonna change the fonts to, let's see, I had them picked out before, and y'all, picking fonts is kind of a pain in the butt to me. It takes me a while to figure out which ones go with what and kind of how they will look together. But if you're not as picky as me, that's great. But I am kind of picky when I put fonts together and pair them. Okay, so the font that I chose was called Basic Beginnings. So I kind of wanted that to be. Okay, and then I want to change Grateful and make that look a little prettier. And I think the font that I had was, I think it's called Buttercup. Yeah, that's it. Okay, so that is good. Now what I'm gonna do, obviously that does not look like that up there. So the way I'm gonna do that is I'm gonna go create outlines. I'm going to ungroup it. And then I'm going to select that. And if you can see right there, obviously they're not welded or united together, so I'm going to go ahead and Pathfinder Unite because I wanted that to be united, and then I'm just going to highlight over the words that I want to move around, and I'm just going to plop them where I want. So this is obviously your preference, however you want. I'm just going to play with it, and let me show y'all how I usually do this. So I actually want this to be engraved, or I want this to be engraved, and I wanted the grateful to be cut out. So I am gonna do a couple of things to make sure that it does that correctly. So first of all, I do not like how that R is super far away, and that is super far away. And then I'm gonna highlight them, and the key is to kind of fit your letters into little spaces so that it looks nice and full. Like here, I've got grateful, and honestly, it would look much cuter if the T was in between both of there, so both are the A and the Y. So I kind of like that better. It just sort of looks like it's supposed to fit together. So I'm gonna do kind of something like that. I'm gonna bring these a little closer to each other. Oh, I don't like that. Okay, you get what I mean. Okay, so I kind of like that. Okay, so then what you're gonna do is you want your machine to create different steps for these. So what you're gonna do is this I want engraved, I also want this engraved, and I also want this engraved. So I'm gonna turn that into one whole step by making that a compound path. And you do that by going to Object, Compound Path, Make. So that right there, now when you can see when I click on it, it's all selected together, and that is one compound path. So your Glowforge software is gonna want to read that as one step. Now, the other thing, so now I want this to be cut, but looking at it, it is not ready to be cut. So what I'm going to do is move the letters a little bit closer to each other so they are stuck together. And I'm noticing that this font has something funny in it. And if you do that. Now I'm double clicking on that and just getting rid of that because you do not want your machine to cut that. And this one has something interesting in here too. Okay. So what I'm gonna do is I put those together. I'm going to unite them, but I'm also going to increase the stroke weight just a bit so that you get a nice cut on it. Now I see, okay, as I was doing that, all these little funky edges are coming out, and the way that you get rid of that is, obviously this font is kind of more of like a brush stroke font, which is fine, but usually when you increase the stroke weight, you get these little funky, little like jagged edges, and that happens from time to time with the font. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go over to my window, open up my stroke window, and I'm going to go ahead and I'm using a new computer, so all of my like toolbars are all messed up. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and change the corners to rounded path and see, as you can see as I did that, here's what it looked like before and here's what it looks like now. So that kind of cleaned that up a little bit, and that's pretty good. I feel like that's pretty nice and thick, although you can see the path is still not fully around it. So we're gonna go to object, expand, path, and then we're gonna unite that too. So that if you didn't do that step, your Glowforge is gonna cut all of these lines and you're gonna get a bunch of mess, and that is not pretty. So I'm gonna go ahead, Pathfinder, unite, and now you see that. So now I'm looking at it closely and I see these little funky dots in here. I'm gonna get rid of them by double clicking them and delete. Okay, and final step with this, I'm going to make this from a fill to a stroke. Sorry, y'all, it's early. Okay, and I'm gonna change the color to red because I want it to be red as a different step. Okay, so the text is done. I'm gonna highlight that, group it, and I'm gonna move it over here. And now I wanna make this circle piece right here. I made it an ellipse with a kind of flat bottom so I could set it on like a shelf. So I'm gonna show you how I did that. Once I get some coffee, of course. Okay, ellipse. And then you're gonna go over here, create your circle. My artboard is the size of what fits in a Glowforge Basic. I have a pro model, but I like to make my artboards that size just so I can get an idea of what it looks like in the machine. So this right here looks like it is about 7 inches by 7 inches. I'm gonna go with that. And then I'm gonna get my rectangle tool and I'm just gonna slice it from the bottom. So the way you do that is you draw a rectangle, highlight both of them, and go over to your Pathfinder and minus front. And now you have a pretty little like flat edge. Okay, now I want to be able to do this little knockout piece in here. So the way we're gonna do that is we are going to go over to, how do we want to do that? Okay, we're going to go to Object, Path, Offset Path, and you can do this two ways. You can do a negative path, or you can just do a positive number. Sorry. Okay, or you could just do, right now I have it set at 0.3, so we're going to do like 0.7. Okay, I think I want that a little bit bigger. So let's undo. I want to do like see what that does. Okay, I kind of like that. So that's kind of like an inch around. So now what you've got is you've got this piece right here and this piece right here. And now I want to get rid of this piece in the middle. Now, what you want to make sure is, let me show you what they look like. What you want to make sure is that this piece is in the front. And you can check by looking at your layers, and you can see that this one is on top. So that's good. And then this one is on the bottom. So if I go here and highlight them both and Pathfinder minus front, I get this. If I did it the other way around and I had this on top, it would not do what I wanted to do. So I'm gonna go ahead and minus front. And now I have this fun little piece that is kind of like the front layer of that board. Okay, then I wanted to go ahead and put a backer on it. You don't need to put a backer on it. The only reason I did is because I wanted to stain it a different color just so it could pop a little bit more. So the way you're gonna get a backer is you take this piece, copy, paste, and joy, copy, paste, and then you're gonna right click on it and release your compound path. When you do that, you'll see that it releases the center, the center piece in there, and then we're gonna highlight it all and we're going to unite it. So now we've got these two pieces. I'm going to turn them from a stroke or a fill to a stroke because I want them cut. And then I've got, okay, a couple more steps on here. There is this piece right here is gonna be your dry erase board that I wanted to be able to take out and in kind of here. So I'm gonna show y'all how I make that. Obviously that's just a triangle or a rectangle. Gosh, I don't know my shapes. What's happening to me? Okay, so what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna make a rectangle and I'm gonna put it like right there. And before I do that, I'm gonna kind of make it how I want it to look. So I kind of like that. And I'm gonna copy and paste it and paste this one on the side because that's the one I'm gonna use to merge them together in a minute. But now I like this. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go over to Object, Offset Path, and I'm gonna create a negative path. I'm gonna do negative 0.0, I don't know. Let's do 0.02. No, I don't like that. That was not what I wanted. I'm gonna do negative 0.02. I forgot my negative over there. Okay, so I kind of like that. And then what I'm gonna do is I have this. So now you can see I've got this piece and I've got this piece and I want to knock this piece out of the middle. Actually, I kind of want it a little bit thicker. So let's undo that and do offset path. Instead of a 0.2, I think I'm gonna do 0.4. Yeah, like that. Okay, so what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna highlight them both and I'm gonna minus front. And then I've got this piece right here. And so this is the piece that it gets to be set on top. Okay, so let's change these colors so you can see what I'm talking about. Let's make that blue, and then I'm gonna make, and then what we're gonna do is we're gonna take this, and you're gonna set it on top, highlight it, and make sure it's aligned by doing your horizontal align center, center, and your vertical align center, so you know they're perfectly centered. Gonna click on this piece and this rectangle that I made, and I'm gonna merge them together by hitting unite. Okay, then I'm gonna send that to the back so you can see what I've done. Okay, this piece right here is gonna be like your little border. And then I want to see over here as I made this kind of little thumb piece so that it's easier for you to take out the dry erase piece and kind of swap it out as you go. So I'm gonna do that. How are we gonna do that? Let's see. We're gonna go ahead and get an ellipse tool. We're going to draw a little circle. Let's change the color so you can see what I'm doing here. Make it red. Okay. So I'm gonna draw a little circle. You can make it bigger if your thumb is super big, but you know, I'm gonna just make it kind of little. And then I'm gonna click on that and click on the border piece that I made and minus front again. And so now that, oh, you know what? Wait, I'm not already yet. Before I do that, see, sometimes I jump ahead of myself. Before I do that, I'm going to select this border piece and then select this middle piece right here. Hit my direct selection tool and I'm gonna curve this a tiny little bit because I don't want it to be like jagged edges. I think I did that on this one and I didn't really like it when I cut it. So this is good. So now I'm gonna have this piece right here, selected it, copy it, and paste it so that I have a separate piece. And I'm gonna make that, I don't know, dark blue, sure. Okay, so now that's the piece that's gonna go in there. And then I'm gonna go ahead and do the step that I was about to do. So now that goes there, and that goes there. So now when you cut it, this is gonna be a separate piece, this is gonna be a separate piece, this is gonna be a separate piece, and this is gonna be a separate piece. Slightly complicated, I know, but you can do it. Okay, then this final piece right here that we did up in the front, up in the beginning, we are gonna take our text, and we're gonna bring it over here, and join it all up and make it pretty. So obviously your text can't really go here because you need to have some kind of a backing or whatever so that it could be engraved on and so that you can cut your letters out with it and then glue it on there. So the way to do that is I'm going to go ahead and copy, and then I'm gonna paste a separate one out here. Let me move this over so it doesn't confuse you. Okay, and then I'm going to go to effect, and I'm going to path, offset path, and I'm gonna make it like, I'm gonna round it, but I think I'm gonna make it like maybe, oh God, no, hold on. I can never get the numbers right on here, you guys. Let's do like 0.2. I don't like that either. What on earth is going on here? Okay, another trick that I always use is, okay, so you see right here that is not large enough. So what I'm gonna do is I am going to go back to effect and apply that effect one more time. And then it makes it a little bit larger. I kinda like that. So let me show you what happens if you do it again. So apply the effect again. It's just gonna make it a little bit larger. It's gonna use the same number on there and just add it on there. So I do not want it that much. So I like that. I'm going to object, expand appearance, and then I'm going to merge it all together by hitting Pathfinder Unite. And see these little holes in here? Some people might want to keep them, I don't. So I'm gonna right click, just like we did before, right click and release the compound path so these little holes get filled in, and then I'm just gonna unite it together. Okay, and then I'm going to show you what color. Okay, so I'm gonna bring this over here, and I want to kind of unite it to this piece right here. So let's bring this over here so you see what I'm doing. Okay, I'm gonna put that like right there. I'm gonna click on the back piece and make sure that some of this is touching here, some of this is touching here, and I'm going to unite them. And when I do that, it brings it all to the front. So I'm gonna send that back to the back. Then I'm gonna take my text, right on top, and there you go. Okay, so at this point, this is basically done. You just want to make this ready to pop into your Glowforge software. So you can save this as an SVG just like this, but once you do, all of these pieces are going to say that they want to be engraved because they're filled. So we're going to go ahead and swap fill to stroke. This is pink, so that's a separate color. This is black, separate color. This is red. I'm gonna swap this light blue. So that's gonna wanna use that as a separate step, and I'm gonna swap that. And there you go. What do you think? Hope that was easy enough for you guys. If you guys make it, I really wanna see what it looks like. All right.